Hi everyone, it is my birthday. I am 20 years old today, feeling very old right now. I'm very sad because I'm still in lockdown, obviously, and the weather is terrible, so it's been sunny for like ages. It's been absolutely boiling, the weather's been amazing, and as soon as it gets to my birthday, it started pouring down and it's like windy as. Because I was going to have my friends around in the back garden, because obviously you're not allowed 6 people in private spaces or gardens, obviously, as long as you distance yourselves. And now I can't, and I don't know when I can, because I don't know when the weather's going to get better, but I'm about to go down and open my presents and I'll be back very soon to show you what I got. So I'm going to be getting ready for my lockdown birthday right now. Very low down. I'm just going to go up. Right, that's better. I've got like this summery dress that was meant to, I had a vision of it being really sunny and I was out in the back drinking like homemade cocktails, chilling in the sun with some sunglasses on and absolutely loving it. But every single year without fail, my birthday, right, on my birthday it rains. So I don't know why I thought this year would be any different, just because it had been sunny for so long. Put some good songs on just to, yeah. Oh my god. All right, well I need a new one of these. I'm also gonna show you my playlist, because why not? This vlog can be a fun vlog. What a song, suitable for the occasion. Honestly, I'm terrible at multitasking. I can't sing and do my good sometimes. But you don't even know nothing about me. Thick thighs, looking and look into my brown eyes. Same on my part, be honest.
Tweaking, tweaking, 120 on the N-way speed and LV back and speakers. Any girl that I'm with is a 10-9.
All I care about is money and this. Has anyone heard the Weeknd's version of this? Because controversial, I think it's better. I'm actually going to put it on now. I do like Drake's version, but the Weeknd one's just... Oh wait, no, I'm gonna put it on there because this bit's my favourite. You know what I like. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I feel like this video is just gonna be me singing my favourite songs.
They try to send for me, envy and jealousy is everything I wish upon my enemies. All that for right back at them. All my mind keeps telling me, cause all my mind I'm running to the money will be running my car.
Hello, been hurt so many times.
Need to get that together so we can get together.
I always ask you to show me a real good time. Listen. Oh, but at least we try. Tell me what you say, come again. If you cannot stay down, then you do not have to pretend. Please don't take this personal. But you ain't shit. You weren't special till I made you so. You better act like you know. He's no wife, he won't ask him. I never listened though. I should've feared it though. All this shit you was spitting so unoriginal. So to finish the look off, I got these for my birthday. Some Prima lashes in, I don't know what one it is. I don't know if it has a D30. And they're really nice. They're like so fluffy. And they're not very long, so I like fluffy eyelashes that aren't really long. They just like open your eyes with it. So I'm gonna put these on now. 30, 60 seconds, so I make the glue go tacky.
Hit me with this, who the fuck wants to be 70 and alone?
This isn't sitting down very well. I probably should have cut them. So I've got one on. with a bit of a struggle. They're actually really nice and they're not long. Sometimes when I get them, they're really long and they kind of touch the top of my eyebrow and I don't really like them, but these, the perfect eyelashes. So this is the finished look. And before I get changed, I'm going to show you what I got for my birthday. So I got this. It's kind of the wrapping paper is pulled this off, but it was still taped down. This is the La Roche-Posay three-step routine for your skin. So it's got the gentle cleanser, because I've got, my skin's kind of sensitive. Not really, but I feel like some products kind of irritate my skin and burn. So I kind of be really careful with what I use. So it's got the gentle cleanser in, which like removes your makeup and all your like your impurities and like cleanse your pores. Then I've got a soothing tone thermal spring water. So this softens, tones and relieves itching and discomfort on your skin. So I think it's kind of a bit like a toner. I already have the La Roche-Posay toner, but I think this is more, I don't really know what the difference is, but it just came with it. I wanted it for the two things that were in it. Then I've got the Calm and Protect Tolerance Sensitive, which soothes and hydrates, reducing skin sensitivity day after day. So this, you have to apply this to your face and neck. And it's basically, it's a moisturiser, but it's kind of soothes and protects it from like being like any sensitivity. Next, I've got this really cute necklace. Oh, I don't know if you, I'm going to try and look at my nails. Every time I come on here, my nails go really bad anyways. Don't know if you can really see if it's gonna focus. Anyways, it says Gemini, which is my star sign. It's from Pretty Little Thing. It's so cute. It's like diamante. And I'm gonna be wearing that today. I want a necklace with my name on, so like a personalised necklace with my name on, and I don't even know where to go because I just want it to be like plain gold. I don't want it to have any like diamante or diamonds in it. Next I got this Lizelle Botanical Balancing Drops. This is meant to be really good. It's like, it's really small. But I think it's like quite expensive and it's really small. So literally that's it. It came in like this massive box. So when I opened it all up to like this morning, it was in like this big box and I had like them little foam pieces things in it. It was just full of them. And then I got it out and it was this. And I'm like, what is the point in that? But basically this is for like reducing redness and your blemishes, and also meant to control the shine on your face. So hopefully that works. Next I got a candle with my initials on because I love candles. It smells really nice. I don't know what scent it is. Topaz and amber scented candle, warm and oriental. It just smells like cleanliness. Like it just smells clean. I just love candles. I have two in my room already, both Yankee candles. This is really nice, it'll go in my room well, because obviously as you can tell, all my room's just white and like them there. These are so cute, by the way. They're from Decenio. I think that's how you say it. And they're not expensive at all. Like, they do really gorgeous prints, like anything you can think of. So if you're looking for any prints for your bedroom, I would definitely tell you to check out Decenio. Then finally I got some Converse for my birthday. They look really big. So this is it. They look really big right here. I haven't got big feet at all. I just have average size feet, but I love them. Can't wait to wear them out. They look, well, they'll look so cute with like a white shirt dress or white denim shorts and white top, just all white or just normal denim. But they're really nice. And I haven't really got any colourful trainers. I think they're a nice colour. I did want them Comes des Carcons ones. Des Carcons ones. And they'd run out of stock of my size everywhere. But to be fair, I feel like it was a blessing in disguise. Because paying £130 for some Converse is like a bit, I don't know, it's a bit of a rip-off. But yeah, these are them. I love the colour. They're so cute. And they're like, I haven't had high top of one like Converse before. I have the white low tops, and I think I have black too, and I haven't worn them since I was like 15. But I don't know, like the high top ones, I feel like a lot of people are starting to wear them again, and I think Converse are just so comfy and they just go with anything. I feel like they're a shoe that I'll never ever go out with trend, because they're like a wardrobe staple that I think everyone needs now. So they're my presents that I've gotten off my family. My boyfriend's coming later to drop my presents off. He's going to have to sit in the back garden if it stops raining. Bless him. But he's going to drop them off, and excited to see what he's got me. And lastly, this is what I'm wearing today, even though it's windy as I'm still in my head it's still summery, so I'm gonna dress like it's summer. I won't go outside, I'll just have it in my house, but I'm gonna have to move myself back a little bit. I got this dress. It's like, I'm not gonna be able to get in. I can show you it on anyways, but I'm just gonna kind of hold it up and show you it. So this is it. It's like a slip dress. It's light pink. I thought it was lilac, to be fair, but it's got like these purple flowers in it, and it's really cute. I feel like it's very open, a lot of side boobs. So I'm gonna wear like a white oversized shirt on top of it, just because I don't think my mum and stepdad would appreciate my nips being out. So it's really nice. I saw it on Chintzia on her Instagram and I loved it straight away, and I was like trying to find it everywhere. I couldn't find it for like a week, then she put a link on a story and I was like, mom. They also do it in a lemon, but that's run out of my size now. So there are my presents. I'm gonna go and get changed into my clothes and I will be right back. So this is my B-day look. Got my new dress on, just got this white shirt on from Collusion. So I need something to like stick it there. Also, I've had to wear a bra with this because it's literally fully open at the side, but it's really nice. I like it. I think it's very nice, even though the weather is awful outside, but no, this outfit's really cute and I'm loving it. I did have a vision, like I did plan my outfit out thinking it would be summery and it's really not, but yeah, I'm liking it. I've had to put a shirt on because, like I said, it's really, really side boob. Fully out, and I don't think my family would appreciate seeing my side boob and my nipples. But no, it's really nice. Like, I like all the, like, the ruched bit here, and then it's kind of tightish. But it's a bit big on me. I'm trying to see if I can, like, show you it a bit more. I can't really. But yeah, this is the finished look. So I'm about to go downstairs. We've ordered Papa John's, so there's lots of pizza downstairs right now. My makeup's gotten very sweaty because since last time I showed you, I'd been downstairs for a bit, so excuse the unnecessary shine. But yeah, but I'm gonna eat lots of pizza. Also, I need to show you is my mum ordered me these cupcakes for my birthday instead of a cake from, there's this woman that lives on my estate and she like done these cupcakes for me. And they're so cool, like I love them so much, I can't wait to show you them. But before I go down, I'm gonna go show you what my boyfriend got me, because I absolutely love everything that he got me and they're amazing. So I got these desk socks. I don't know if you've seen them before, but I've seen a lot of people have them. I'm gonna take them out of packet actually to show you them. So these are them. That's like where you're at, like it goes around your ankle and they're so cute. Like imagine them with like some white Air Force or any white trainers, like in a little dress. Mm. And they're so nice. And I don't have any nice socks. Like all I have is like black ones from Asda or something, and I lose them all the time. So hopefully I don't lose these. But I just think they're so cool. And I kind of want to start buying nicer socks to wear, because I've struggled to, like most socks I have ruin a, like an outfit because of how like just basic and horrible they are. But I think I just want some like, they do like these pink tie-dye Nike ones on the ASOS marketplace. So I think I'm gonna buy some of them, but these are cute and I like guests, so. Then next, he got me this Champion jumper. It's really cute. I would never, like, I don't know, I'd never buy, I don't own anything from Champion and I always want something. I always see stuff I want from there. So it's so cute that he found a jumper that I love, and that's by Champion, because I really wanted something by there because I do the, like really nice like just chill clothes. Like I love what this is, and it's up there with one of my favorite ones. But I got this Dior crop top. It's from a place called Beaufits. So I told him about this because I had ordered one from Depop, but because of everything that I'd went on with obviously the coronavirus and that, I had to get a refund because I couldn't get any of the supplies. So I'm really sorry, which is fair enough. And then I was really sad. So he got me one and it's so nice. I imagine that with some white shorts or like a white joggers. It kind of is the same material as a bikini too. Then I got the matching headband too. It's quite small, so I don't know how it's going to fit on. I'm going to try on actually, because I don't know how it's gonna work. I don't care what anyone thinks about how I look in this. I actually think, I don't know if I should wear it like that, where it's fully on. Okay, I actually don't care what anyone thinks about how I look in this. I actually really like it. So my earrings have just like been ragged out by these. So it's quite small. I must have a really big head. Then lastly, I've wanted, like, don't even get me started. The shoe of dreams is now mine. These, I mean, beautiful leather. I've never, is it possible to be in love with the shoe? Because, homeboy gonna like, get it. I'm very excited to wear them shoes. So that is what I got off my boyfriend. And then, yeah, I just wanted to share my gifts with everyone because I basically just wanted to show my husband stuff because I love them. So yeah, I'm now gonna go down and I'm gonna go show you my cupcakes. So let's go. So these are the cupcakes for my birthday. Three have already gone, so sorry about that. But how cool are they? They've got Bratz on. Because I loved Bratz when I was younger. I was never a Barbie girl. But look, none of them look like me. But how cute. Looks like me and the gang. But I never really get a cake for my birthday. Never mind made for me. And these are so cute. There were three ones that I'd went were the like least best looking ones. These are the best ones I've had anyways. And I love how my name has been brought in like the kind of font that the Bratz one is. But they're so cute. They can't. I don't want to eat them. Like, at all. I just want to keep them there, but obviously they need to be eaten, so.
Oh my god, I'm very oily. I used this moisturiser that came as a free sample with this skincare stuff I ordered a couple of weeks ago from Look Fantastic. It's La Roche-Posay. I'm never using it again. But yeah, I've gotten into my comfies. I'm going to use my stuff that I got for my birthday. So the first cleanser that I can is like tiny. I think I might have got like the mini version. So I don't know whether to use that yet. No, actually I'm gonna use it, so I'm gonna wash my face up now. I'm not gonna do it on camera because I'm just gonna water all over my face. But yeah, my birthday's been really nice today considering like the circumstances. It's actually been okay. I feel like all of a sudden I've just broken out with like loads of spots and it's really annoying me. I don't know if it's like hormonal spots. No, I'm just going to use my simple cleansing purifying lotion that I always use. Grab another one of them to rub it in with. Now I'm going to try the thermal spring water. I wonder if it's good. Calms and reduces skin irritation. I think it's a bit like a toner. I'm going to let this dry and I'm going to put my toner on. Now I'm going to be using my La Roche-Posay toner. So this is kind of similar, but this is actually like a really refreshing toner. I don't like one. This is like much better than one that you would put on your face, like as a liquid and put it on with like a cotton pad. It's also meant to be really good for razor burns, but ever since I got this, I haven't like cut myself with a razor, thankfully and surprisingly. But then next, I'm just going to be putting my Agra Line solution on. From The Ordinary, I think that's how you pronounce it. This is basically just for fine lines. But it says you can put it on your forehead, but ever since I've like put it on my forehead, I've got a spot that's appeared. But I put some drying lotion on yesterday, like Mario Badescu's one, and it's like went down loads, to be fair. Even though I've heard a lot of bad things about Mario Badescu and I've kind of slagged it off myself, it actually has really helped it. It's went down loads. I'm really, really excited to try this one. It's Lizelle Balance and Botanical Drops. And it's to help like reduce blemishes and like help clean you like impurities and pores. And it also like is meant to get rid of like shine and kind of mattify your face. I'm very excited to see how this is. Works like over the next few days, see a difference in my skin. So I will let you know in a few days if it's worth it, because it was like £26. Like this, like tiny bottle. Hopefully it's like a miracle in a bottle, because I kind of need stuff like that. I think you put it all over you first. Or you can mix a single drop in your moisturiser. Well, I'm going to put this on before my moisturiser. I don't use that. I don't know like how much too much is. So I'm just going to let that kind of dry and set into my face. But I've heard like really good stuff about that. It seems like loads of man's love Lizelle. I've used the hot cloth cleanser before. I didn't really know what it was, and that's good. But I've never like bought anything before from it, and I saw this and I was like, oh, I might ask my birthday and see. And if I like it, I can like continue to buy it myself. But it's for oily, blemish prone skin, and my face isn't necessarily oily, but it's also not dry. It's more on the oily side than like dry. But I feel like my skin's very like prone to blemishes and stuff. Like I've got all these here now that I've came out, and one above my lips, so hopefully this helps. Then next I'm going to be trying out the new moisturiser that came with the 3-step routine set. This is for apparently sensitive skin, because my skin is kind of sensitive. Like some products really irritate my skin.
So that is my skincare routine finished. This moisturiser feels really nice. I want a moisturiser that feels like it's gone like deep in, like not just on surface level, like not that it just sits out. I want it to kind of like feel like it's really soaking in, and it feels so far. I give it a 10 out of 10. See if I wake up tomorrow with either crusty skin or like extremely, extremely oily one. Because I used that free sample one yesterday. My face felt like grease, like it felt like it was just gonna slip off, and it like wasn't very good. I feel like that's, but I imagine if you had like really dry like skin where it would like get all crusty and flaky, it would be perfect for it. I'll try and find it and link it below for you if you suffer with like really dry skin. But I don't suffer with dry skin at all, so I kind of just wanted to use it to see what it would be like, and I probably shouldn't have. It is now the Monday after my birthday. I totally forgot to end the video. I'd finished my skincare and it just ended, and then I went to bed, and then I woke up and I was like, I haven't finished it. And then I didn't, but then the weather, well, it's a bit cloudy now, but it's meant the wind's just meant to blow over and it'll get sunny again. But I've decided to carry the vlog on today. My friends are coming round into the garden, so we're gonna have some like drinks and snacks in the back garden. Yeah, so I'm about to get ready now. I never like carried a video on to another day. I've normally just done it in that time space in one day and then just ended it. So I'm excited to see how it turns out. But yeah, I'm just gonna get ready now. It is 12 o'clock. They're coming around at 3. It wasn't meant to rain at all, and now it's like, it's got a 30% chance of rain, and I don't know if it's definitely going to. But there are some like dark clouds currently, but I feel like they're just going to blow over, because sometimes there is clouds, but they just blow over. Then the sun will come back out. But it is meant to be cloudy anyway, so I think it might just be cloudy, because some of them are really, really dark. And I imagine that's when it's going to rain, when they get over here. But I don't think they're going to come here yet. It's not meant to rain until like 3, 4 anyways. I will see you afterwards, and I'm going to just vlog me setting up outside, try and put my table in a suitable way so that we can social distance instead of sitting right next to each other. But yeah, I have to cook and everything. Like I'm gonna try and make like a kind of platters, and I've bought pizzas and stuff for us to have, so I'm gonna attempt to set it out all nice. And my mum or my stepdad aren't in either to help me, so I'm gonna have to do it all by myself. Well, to be fair, my sisters are in, but they're like 13 and 15, so I don't know if they'll be that much help, but they're going to have to help me because I will not be able to do that myself. So check back to see how I'm going to cope. So I'm all ready for my garden party. My hair, I've got ultimate bedhead, so I'm going to go straighten it now and put on my clothes. Then I'm going to set up. And everyone's gonna come round, and I'm hopefully gonna do a sit or shot video, or never have I ever one, but that's gonna be on a separate video, so make sure to look out for that when it comes out. So I'm gonna go straight my hair. I'm not gonna do it on camera because it takes me forever. The hair, my hair, man. Hey everyone, I am all dressed, cute. I'm wearing my Dior inspired crop top. I don't know whether to wear the headband. I feel like that would be too much. I got my white PLT shorts on, my collision shirt, and I got my guess socks on. Looking extra fine. I'm gonna also put my Jordans on to complete the outfit, because I'm gonna look amazing. So I'm about to go downstairs and set up.
I'm hungry.
So this is a homemade cocktail I've made. It has got raspberry, hoochin, the blue WKD, lemonade and gin. It was meant to like blend in from pink to blue, but it's gone purple. It tastes nice though. And then here's my snacks. I'm about to put pizzas in. Right, I'm about to start setting everything up. This is my little cake stand to put my cupcakes, donuts and stuff on. Time to see if I've listened to my mum and watched her every time she does stuff like this for parties, because she always goes all out, so hopefully she taught me well. So, I'm gonna start, I don't know which one first. Right, these are the cupcakes. I already showed you these, but ooh, how cute. So I think they all have like one each. I think maybe, I don't know. So there's five. Right, so there's like two there, one in the middle. Now I'm gonna put the donuts. I've washed my hands, by the way, no germs. I'm trying to make them look neat. My friends are gonna look back and watch this and think, what the fuck there? Aww, looks quite cute. Right, so there it is. I can't lift it up. I'll try and like, oh. Right, I'm not showing you, so I'll have to just tip the camera up. Sorry, girls, one fell on the worktop. Now, for Georgia, because she's vegan, I'm gonna have to put, I'm gonna put hers on a separate plate, because I don't know if she likes it even mixing in with stuff that's not vegan. I don't know, but I'm gonna be a good friend, go all out for her and put some stuff on, like a nice cute little thing for her. And put some Oreos out for her. She has asked for breadsticks too, with hummus, and I went to go, we already had hummus in, and I came back and it had run out of date. Then I got these free from the Rocky Road mini bites, and the, because free from usually just means like gluten and wheat. This is actually free from milk and eggs, so it's got dark chocolate in. It's basically for vegans, so I'm just gonna pour them in. And this is that one, I'm gonna put that over here. Then I also got some popcorn, because that is also vegan and everyone likes popcorn. I've just took my washing out and I've just left it there while I've done this. I'm gonna go move it now before my mum sees this and shouts it. Sorry, mum! I'm gonna put the popcorn in this. And that's got that. It's the prettiest bowl I could find. Then I've got some crisps, so I'm gonna have to put them in a bowl, because obviously dipping our hands in and out won't be, it's probably against the rules of the guidelines given by the government for social distancing and the coronavirus, so I just put them in things, because we won't want all of them. I'm gonna have to remember which one's which. There's one salt and vinegar, one's Texas barbecue sauce. There's still some left for me to snack on later when they all go. There is gonna be six of us, and I feel like I've bought loads of stuff because I went to Tesco and it only came for like £31. So I don't, and then I've also got two pizzas, garlic bread chicken and garlic dips. Oh, and I've also, one's okay. Then I also got chocolate, strawberries dipped in chocolate. I'm gonna leave these out for it. They've been in the fridge overnight. Oh, because I was meant to get dark chocolate for Georgia and I forgot it, so I've had to just leave some strawberries for her. On. Sorry. Then that's that for food. I'm gonna show you it all now. So there we go. I'm actually pretty proud of myself. Mum will be very proud of me too. Where's one of them gone? Oh, there. So it's like that. I kind of set it out cute. Then, I don't know where I put the breadsticks, you can just eat them out of the bucket. No, no. Well, I can't. I like it with meal. There's popcorn, Oreos, Rocky Roads, donuts, cupcakes, crisps, and I'm going to put the pizzas in when they come. Yeah, so I'll put them in when they come, because I know they'll say that they're on the way and I'll put them in and then they'll go cold, because they won't be, they'll actually have not even set off yet, and they'll have set off like an hour later. So I don't have that much trust in them. So I'm going to wait till they come. Then we have snacks out still while we're waiting. We're probably gonna waste all this food, which is quite sad, but to be fair, my sisters probably have some and the dog. So yeah, I hope this, they all like this, because it's really nice. It basically just tastes like WKD with a bit of, it's quite, it's not, well, I find anything strong really, so I think this is really strong. It's in like a giant wine glass that we have, and I thought it's cool to use this. And everyone will be like, hmm. I hope I impress everyone with my hostess skills.
I am now going to bring everything outside. Drinks in, so we don't have to come in the kitchen to keep them cold. So just gonna fill. I'm gonna turn the music off. Alexa, stop. Clean this up with water. So we're gonna put the drinks in. Probably won't keep them that cold. It's the thought that counts. And I'm done. That was a workout and a half. Morning. It's the next day. It was a really good night. I feel quite fresh, to be fair. I did expect to have a bit of a hangover because I hadn't seen my friends in a while and I thought we might have took it too far. But we didn't. And I didn't drink loads. I drank a bit, but not loads. So I feel quite fine. But it was really nice seeing everyone. I'm just feeling very grateful because I've had the best few days with my birthday. And it's been nice seeing like people that I haven't necessarily seen in a long, like in a while. So yeah. I also want to point out my description box, if you might have forgot my message at the beginning of the video, if you're still watching now, that I've linked a few petitions in my description box. Like, I've tried to gather a few together because I didn't just want to link just like a few for the same thing. I feel like there needs to be awareness brought to loads of different types of things to do with this movement. Like, it's not the thing that happened in America, is it's not just happened once. There's a lot of other stuff that needs to be changed too. So I've tried to link as many as I can to also bring awareness to other stuff. I just want everyone to realize how important it is to do this and make sure you use your voice when you have like the privilege to just use your voice. It's not much, just help as much as you can when you have the power to help, when your voice will be heard, because some people's voices aren't heard and they're just screaming. But my friend Georgia Wilcock on her YouTube channel, she's made a playlist of loads of YouTubers that are donating all their money from their AdSense, from their videos. So if you can't afford to donate, then you can watch their videos. Even if like you put it on and just put your phone down and just let it play through, even do that. Like, you don't have to watch the video, just it's just helping. So if you can, even if you have the time, just check that out now. It's on her YouTube channel. Just type in Georgia Wilcock, and on her playlist, she has one made of a lot of YouTube videos that are donating money to certain charities and stuff for this movement. But thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.